In this lesson, we're talking about letting our users into our Asset Framework server. Now, the good thing is that the security model is almost exactly the same as on the PyData archive. You create identities, give those identities permission to do things, and then map domain users and groups to them. But before we go into the configuration, it's important to know how user connections work when connecting to Asset Framework. So here's us. We want to use PyDataLink. PyDataLink is the Pi System's plugin to Microsoft Excel. So we want to put the most recent value of a pump's temperature in a cell on our report. So when we execute the query, Excel connects to the Asset Framework server. After authentication through a mapping and approval from the server, it asks, I want the current value of pump 01's temperature. AF doesn't return a value, it returns a pointer. Something like /pysrv01/pump01.ts.pv. So PyDataLink automatically sees that this is a reference to a Pi point and instantly goes to PySRV01, authenticates, and then asks, what's the current value of pump01.ts.pv? The PyData archive returns 14.6. Then PyDataLink shows the value on the spreadsheet. It also remembers some of the context it grabbed from AF and might have units and some other metadata that goes along with it. It isn't just PyDataLink that does this, but all Pi system clients make independent connections to both the PyData archive and AF server. This is why a connecting user will need access to both the data archive and Asset Framework servers independently, no matter how they're accessing the data. Now in this lesson, we'll configure our Asset Framework server to minimum best practices. We're going to configure our user access for administrators, who will always have full access to everything, users who'll have read-only access to everything, and power users who'll have read-write access to a special development database on the server. Here we are on PySRV01. We're going to open Pi System Explorer. So click Start, navigate down to Pi System, and then run Pi System Explorer. You can run this tool from really anywhere. Usually in real life, we'd be running it from our own laptop rather than remoting into the server and running it, especially not the PyData archive. But we've opened it up now. Let's make that full screen. And we get connected to our database one that we created when we tested that Asset Framework was installed properly right at the beginning of this course. So we're going to click on the database button. Now we see here a list of our databases. Now we've got two of them. We've got configuration and we've got database one. Database one, we created when we first installed the server. And configuration stores configuration data for various Pi system applications. This isn't really a database that's navigated to by users. Now, just in preparation for the following exercise, we're going to rename this database one. We're going to rename it to production. And we're going to create a new database. And this is going to be called development. Now, there's a lot of reasons why you might have multiple databases in Asset Framework. You may have one, like here, for development and production. You may have different databases for different applications. Maybe you have a custom application that requires data to be set out in a very specific way. Maybe you have different databases for different user groups and set up security differently between them. Now we're going to use this as a little bit of an example, because later we're going to configure security so our power users can modify our development database, but not our production database. Speaking of security, let's take a look. So the place to go to here is Show Properties. This will show the properties of the Asset Framework server we're connected to. We see a whole lot of tabs here. The ones we're interested in are the mappings and the identities tabs. These work in very much the same way as the PyData archive identities and mappings. So let's take a look at how security is configured so far. If we look at the mappings, we have the local administrators group mapped to administrators, and the Windows everyone group mapped to world. This is the default configuration for Asset Framework servers, and really a placeholder until you put in a better security model. It's not intended that you'll just leave this in here. It's inherently very insecure and really only there to allow you to access it for the first time. We're going to go ahead and configure our admins, users, and power users mappings here. First off, the administrator mapping. So rather than the local administrators group, I'd like a mapping from my Pi admins group. So let's make a new mapping. Right click in the white space and new mapping. Now the account we'd like, if we click on search, is Pi administrators. Pi AD and then check names will do you. Okay. We'd like to map that to administrators. So administrators is an identity that comes by default with the Asset Framework server that has access to everything. Now we have this old built-in administrators mapping here. We're going to go ahead and remove this. It's really not best practice to use local groups in your security. You want to standardize on using domain groups. So we're going to right-click and delete. Okay. Now we're going to create a mapping for our users. We've got this everyone mapping up the top, where everyone that tries to connect will just be let in under this world identity. Instead, we're going to make another one. So we'll right-click and make a new mapping. Our account is going to be Pi users. And our identity, we're going to take advantage of this world identity that's already in place. Now we have Pi users in here. We're going to go ahead and delete this everyone identity here. Okay, I'm feeling better already. Now, the final mapping is for our power users. Before we make a mapping though, we'll need an identity. So we're going to flick over to identities, and we're going to make a power users identity. Okay. We may as well make the mapping here while we're configuring the identity. It allows us to create a mapping straight away. So we're going to map. And here we're going to select our Pi Power Users group. Okay. So that's looking good. We're going to go OK on there. Go back to our mappings. And we see the power users mapping in there now as well. Now there's one last thing I'd like to do with power users, which is give them permission to edit the development database. So we're going to go OK on here. And we're going to right click on the development database and then click on security. Now every part of Asset Framework allows you to configure who is allowed to do what at every level. The security gets very granular. We're not going to go through specific settings on specific parts of the database. We're just going to give the power users full control over this development database. If you're interested in looking at the granular security controls, then check the documentation. We'll reference it to the side. Now this development database, we have everything selected up the top. So all parts of our development database. We're going to add in our power users. And give them full control. So we're going to go OK here. And that's that for security configuration. There's a few things I wanted to show you before we leave though. I'm going to go back into the server properties here. And then click on connections. Here I have everyone that's currently connected to my Asset Framework server. This is a very useful way for you to see which of your clients is currently connected and who are they connecting as. Another thing I'd like you to see is effective permissions. So if we cancel this and go back into the security options we were looking at before with the development database, I can right click and click on security, and I can click on effective access. Now I'm going to select a user account up the top. I'm going to click on the magnifying glass, and I'm going to type in student 02. Student 02 is actually in our users group. So let's see what they have access to here. Okay. They're logging in as world, and they have read permission to development, analyses, read and read data, etc. So we can see exactly what they can do. Now I'm going to search for student 03. Student 03 is in the power users group. So let's see what they can do. Okay, their identities are power users and world. And I can see that they have really full control over every object in this database. So this is a very useful tool to see what kind of effects your security changes have made. Now our security is all set up. Asset Framework is ready to be built. So we have our development database and our production database. Really from here, I'd expect my power users to go into my development database. They would build out a structure that is useful for certain projects in the organization. Then my administrator would port over their work to the production database, and users will be able to see it. Now, we don't cover actually building the database in this course. That's covered in other courses under our Power User course series.